Hello and a warm welcome to day three of our Drynamic Mobility Show. After we've already given you interesting insights into the topics of sustainability and autonomous driving, our topic today will be alternative drives. Next to me, my colleague Markus Feeth, our head of automotive. Markus, especially in Europe, we're currently seeing that more and more OEMs are turning their backs regarding the consumption engines. What does igus for this?
Okay, what does it mean for igus at the end? As you said, it's mainly a theme right now in the European Union, because the whole issue with social responsibility, supply chain management is getting more and more important. That means expert expect that in 2030 in the Chinese market and in the United States there are still a percentage of 50% gasoline cars or hybrid cars in the market. So it's not as tough as you might expect when you just read the daily news. However, we have many applications with our bushings, and we see that some of them are not used anymore or getting down significantly, like turbocharger, ABS pumps, throttle bodies, and we see other applications, the whole interior design, which is getting more flexible, and the thermo management, which are getting more and more important and which are generating more and more applications.
Some of the main benefits of alternative drives are the reduced risk regarding health and environment, as well as the flexible mobility. But there are also some challenges for the technology. In winter, as well as in summer, the range of electric vehicles drops significantly. The reason for that is that the cooling and the heating cycles is supported by the battery as well. For that reason, the range of the car can drop to up to 40%. Markus, what kind of solutions igus got for thermal management?
You're totally right, Jonas. The whole theme thermal management is getting more and more important. And let me show you the details about water pumps. Water pumps and cooling systems are becoming more and more important, not only for gasoline engines, also for electrical cars, because we want to reach very quickly a good temperature range for the classical gasoline engine, so that we are running on a low emission level. And therefore the cooling systems today are turned on and off. They are not running continuously anymore as it was in the old times. Electrical cars, on the other side, also need cooling in summer and a little heating in the winter time. So means cooling systems, and that means not only the cooling pump, also the actuator, so the system which is controlling the cool metal, the cooling flow, the cooling media flow to the different areas, to the different aggregates, is very flexible. So what is important for bushing into such cooling systems? Of course, we must have the resistance against the water glycol media over long time, over temperature. And how do we reach that? So with our bushings, we have a very special fiber and a very special fiber surface, which is taking care of the connection to the basic polymer, so that we have a good sticking together of the whole matrix of the bushing. And that is responsible for having a good chemical resistance. On the other side, for the water pump, it is extremely important that we need a good media flow, so that we are getting hydrodynamic effects.
How can we help with our bushing to achieve that? So we have the possibility, if needed, to have special grooves in the bushing, also on the radial and on the axial side of the bushing, so that we get a good media flow and that we get hydrodynamic effects. This is important for any bushing. If it's our IGUS polymer H370 bushing, or if it's a graphite bushing, we all need that hydrodynamic effects. What other benefits do we offer with our bushings? So we are able to overmold our part with plastic. And we can help you to set up such process so that we get a recalibration of the bushing during the overmolding process at, of course, higher temperatures. So we are able to offer a thermal recalibration that we get a good clearance situation, which helps us also to have a low noise pump. So we would be pleased to support you, to help you with your overmolding process. Maybe contact our technical engineering support and use our knowledge.
Markus, besides thermal management, are there any other aspects, maybe in the interior, which are new?
Of course. We see, as I said already, a lot of more flexibility because we are not anymore used the full time as a driver, so we can work, we can relax, we can chill out. And so we have much more flexibility in the interior design, which is generating more and more applications for us. And because we are not needed anymore the full time as a driver, the whole steering wheel can be folded together in the dashboard, and it's only moving out when we need to take control again.
Yeah, very interesting insights into the development of the future applications in the interior car. I think that's it for today. Thank you very much for attending. We are now happy to answer your questions on Microsoft Teams. And of course, we are available to take you on an individual exhibition walk if you're interested. So please text us, talk to us, and we can have an appointment. Tomorrow, the topic will be aerodynamics. I guess that's your topic as well, Markus.
Yes, I'm looking forward again.
So stay tuned. Make sure to tune in tomorrow, and goodbye.